Next guest is a very well-respected journalist who brought the world of beautiful books to our television screens, but now she is moving on to the next chapter in her wonderful life and a special new role. Please welcome the fabulous Jennifer Byrne.
Right, you've gone from the first Tuesday book club to the last Tuesday book club.
I know, and it's just the last one's coming up in December. Wow. The last one.
Is it mixed emotions?
Look, I mean, I wept. I mean, you know, it's such a deep and wonderful thing that I've loved it. I've loved it, like I've loved all my jobs, but I've never loved emotionally like I've loved that, you know, just to be in the world of books. It's a beautiful thing. But you know what? I had 11 years.
Wow.
And Natasha, that is the longest job I've ever held.
Really?
And it's really important when you are, you want to be a multi-trick pony. You don't want just one trick. And it was time.
Can't get too comfortable.
You know? That's right. It's time. And I just, you know, like, I don't, like, we all run our careers. You know, it just, sometimes you just know it's time. It's a beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. Let's leave it as a beautiful thing. And Jimmy Barnes came in and sang for us, and he sang Flame Trees, and we all burst to tears. I know.
We've already cried once on the show.
I know.
That was the song played at Pete's funeral yesterday, was Flame Trees. Yeah, acoustic. Yeah.
By Ian Moss.
Well, it's just, well, it's about looking back.
It is.
And I think, you know, for us it was like, because we all love each other on the book show, despite all the arguments. And, but it's just been the most fantastic thing. And I've worked since I was 16, and it's time for a year off.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Well, good on you making that decision. And isn't it, I just think it's so lovely to be able to do something you love for such a long period of time, but then to make that decision, okay, time for a change. Over those 11 years, is there a particular book that stands out for you? Something that you could say, this is a favourite, or this is something that has changed me? I mean, books change us all in different ways.
I'll tell you, and look, it's really, we've done, you know, over 200 books, or I don't know how many hundreds of books, and, but I would say the book that we did recently is one that I, whenever I mention it, you know, I'll try not to start crying, but it's this beautiful, and it's the classic story, because it was a book club, when I set up a book club, I'd never been in a book club before, so I went to a friend's book club, it had been going for 20 years, and studied how book clubs worked, and then bent all the rules. And she recommended this book called Our Souls at Night.
Oh, yes.
Have you read that?
Yes.
Against Her Roof.
That's extraordinary.
It's an extraordinary book. And it's just a beautiful story about simple tale, simply told, full of passion and beauty and wonder at life. And it's, she gave it to me and said, you should think about this for your book club. I brought it to book club. Everyone just went ballistic. Mm. It's very hard to find in the shops now because, you know, they get new copies. And
can I ask, Jen, because I haven't read that book, but I will pretend that I have.
Have you ever,
once in your 11 years, your hundreds and hundreds of books, was there ever a time where you didn't quite finish the book, didn't quite do the thing, and just sort of skimmed over it and sort of just faked your way through it?
Shaken. No.
Never?
Never.
Was there ever a time on the show where you thought, hang on, you haven't really read this to one of the other panelists?
So that, you know, only you just once someone
read
actually
the last page?
Came on and confessed. Lee Sales was doing a Christmas special with us about that year's big book, Our Little Life, and she just said, oh, I couldn't read it, didn't like it, it made me feel really upset. I was like, do you not know the rules?
We had her on the show in that seat just yesterday.
That book, though,
when she came back,
she is fake news.
Cheater.
I'm taking it.
She's
that's right.
That book, though, is very arduous, and it's like, oh.
And that's what
you've got to be in the right frame of mind, I think, to read it.
That's what made it such a good thing, because you got into a discussion. Yep. It's like, honesty is everything. Yep.
Mm. I've been halfway through Crime and Punishment since about 1997. So
half or a third.
Or maybe closer to a third. Maybe closer to a third.
I just finished reading.
I've got the crime, but not the punishment.
I just finished reading up, Bring Up the Bodies.
Mantel. Isn't it fantastic?
Mm. Adored.
And you know the third.
And what am I going to do now?
Well,
my girlfriends in Queensland are going to be furious because we just get the books off you on the TV and I've got the poops about it now.
Oh. Well, you know what? The thing is, Hilary Mantel, having won a booker with both of those books, she was meant to produce the third in the series this month.
Oh, but she hasn't.
No, there's a lot of talk in the book world. And what's happened to Hillary?
Jen, an important campaign that you've taken on now is, of course, Coast Trek. Tell us about
that.
It's wonderful.
Well, look, it is a wonderful thing, and it's part of this you know, I will go back to work, but I just wanted a period of it. This is my gap year.
Sure.
And I have become friends over the years with Di Westaway, who founded Coast Trek.
Yes.
Which is this 30 and 60K. Oh, there it is, 60K. Yeah. The one struggling is me. along the coast, along those beautiful parts of the coastline. And I have always been a person who loves health and fitness. Mm. And what I like about Coast Trek is it's not about being, oh, it's really important that you go and walk and, you know,
yeah, yeah.
It's about, this is a beautiful part of the world. Mm. When you walk through it, you do feel physically better because you're breathing, but your mind feels better.
Yes.
And it's that combination of natural exhilaration.
It is beautiful and it is its own reward, but you're also doing it for Fred Hollows, I believe, which is just the most magnificent organisation. Yeah. I think they're making 1 million people a year now can see where once...
Vast. Well, you know, when I was at 60 Minutes, I went to Nepal with Fred Hollows. Mm. Yeah. And so, in fact, it was Fred Hollows that brought me to Coast Trek, and I've stayed for...
Isn't that beautiful?
There's a very strong link.
And also,
I love Gabby Hollows, and, you know, it's just all works for
fantastic.
Me.
Yeah.
And it's a team, too, that you can join a team and do Coast Trek, and I think that's what's such a lovely...
Well, I went with four women.
Yeah.
Four women.
What a treat to do that. And chat and chat and walk and chat.
Oh, no, we didn't speak at all.
No.
Not a word.
To register for Sydney Coast Trek or Melbourne Coast Trek, you can head to coasttrek.com.au. You are wonderful. Jennifer Byrne, thank you so much for joining us.
Such a pleasure to be here.
See you.